This former lawyer and fixer for a decade reportedly has spent many hours talking to Robert Mueller's team over the past month. ABC News says much of the questioning of Michael Cohen dealt with Mr. Trump's dealings with Russia. We're also following breaking news on the president's U.S. Supreme Court nominee. Brett Kavanaugh's accuser, Christine Blasey Ford, says she's willing to testify next week if the terms are fair. She also says she won't do it on Monday. Joining us now to discuss all of this, Jake Sullivan, a former top advisor to both Hillary Clinton and Joe Biden. He's currently a lecturer at Yale Law School. Jake, thanks very much for coming in.
Thanks for having me.
So you worked with Hillary Clinton's 2016 campaign when the Russians engaged in cyber warfare against that campaign. Do you think Michael Cohen could shed some serious light in his interviews with Robert Mueller's team about any possible coordination, conspiracy, collusion, whatever you want to call it, between the Trump camp and the Russians?
Of course he could. I mean, given how close he is to the president and the president's family, he could shed light on what the Trump campaign knew about the hack of the DNC, what the Trump campaign knew about the hack of John Podesta, what the Trump campaign knew about the information operations through social media that the Russian intelligence agencies were conducting, and the extent to which the Trump campaign was either encouraging those things or facilitating them. And so I think all of that is something that Mueller should be fully exploring, and ostensibly Michael Cohen will have to tell the truth because he'll be talking to federal law enforcement officials.
And do you think potentially he has information on another aspect of the Mueller investigation, obstruction of justice?
This is another area where he is going to be an absolutely key witness. As Preet Bharara was saying in the last segment, this ultimately comes down to the president's state of mind. Did President Trump decide that he was going to fire people, that he was going to make decisions with the express purpose of frustrating the investigation into what happened in 2016? It certainly appears that he did, and Michael Cohen would be the person who could shed light on the president's state of mind.
Let's get to some other sensitive issues. Google is just now revealing that foreign government hackers have now been targeting the private Gmail accounts of U.S. senators, Senate staff of both parties. Is the government, the federal government, prepared to confront this ongoing threat?
I think the short answer is no, and you don't have to take that from me. Various intelligence officials have testified before Congress that they do not have all the tools they need to be able to push back against and counter Russian interference in our political process. And that's in no small part because the president of the United States simply will not take this threat seriously. As somebody who was the subject of these attacks in 2016, I know how relentless they can be, and I know what the results can be, as we saw from the leaked information from the DNC and John Podesta.
When you say you were the subject, personally or the campaign?
Both the campaign and I was the subject, as has been reported, of phishing attacks during 2016, where they tried to hack my email just as they were hacking John Podesta's and others.
Was any of that phishing successful in your
case? We don't believe that it was.
In your case?
No, we don't believe that it was. But the point is that you can see quite clearly what the Russian playbook is, how they would try to execute this against people they believe are opposed to the president or opposed to their positions. And the United States government should be doing much more to combat it than they
So when Google says that foreign government hackers are trying to go after the private Gmail accounts of senators, Senate staff, is that the Russians mostly or other countries?
Look, there's a history of other governments, including the Chinese, trying to get into the email accounts of prominent political figures. The Chinese have tended to do it simply to gain information about policy issues or who's important as an advisor to a presidential candidate, that kind of thing. The Russians do it to weaponize it, to leak it in an effort to influence the outcome of the election. My guess is that when Google talks about that, they aren't just talking about Russia, but Russia is number one on the list in terms of the hostile foreign powers coming at us.
On the confirmation of Judge Kavanaugh to the United States Supreme Court, from your perspective, you've spent a lot of time studying this. What would a fair hearing involving the accuser and the accused look like?
Well, first of all, it's very difficult in a charged partisan environment, especially when you've got 10 men occupying the Republican side
11.
Of the aisle. 11 men, my apologies.
10 Democrats, 11 Republicans.
Right. And all 11 Republicans are men, to have a fully fair hearing. That being said, I think as long as the accuser, Dr. Ford, is allowed to give her story fully and fairly and not be badgered or berated or a lot of the things that Anita Hill was subject to a quarter century ago, then it is possible that we could have a fair hearing here. And of course, Judge Kavanaugh should have the right to respond to that as well. And